Hey guys, and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to make the Power Out bracelet. This is my original design, and it is made with the loom in rectangular configuration. Here is another example. This one just has a single color in the center instead of alternating colors. So, to get started, now for the supplies, you will need your loom, and as I said before, it has to be in rectangular configuration. You need a hook, a C-clip. Where did that C-clip just go? Oh, okay. There it is. Sorry. For the border, so like the neon green, in this, you will need 28 rubber bands, and I will be using white. That's a lot of white. Okay. And for the zigzags, you will need 12 bands total, and I'm using 4 different colors, so I'm using 3 bands of each color. Now, to get started, so you take your first border band across from the left to the center, and for this bracelet you won't be using the right far right pin bar at all. Then you take your first zigzag band and you'll place that diagonally from the left corner to the second center, and then you'll place 2 border bands, one on each side, like that. Then you take your next zigzag diagonally from the right to the left, diagonally, and then add 2 border bands on top of that. So your next border band is diagonally from the left to the center, or the right. I might call this the center, I might say to the right, because it's both, technically. You add your 2 border bands on each side, one on each side, then a diagonal band to the left, and add a border band on the left and one in the center. And you'll continue doing this to the end of the loom. The last band you place in between the top left and top center pins, like that. And then you put a cap band on this top center pin, so like right there. And then you turn your loom around, and now it's time to start looping. So first of all, you just push back the cap band and pick up the band underneath that. I'll loop that band to the right. Then go back into the cap band, the left side, because the center row is now the left side, now that you've turned it around. And then on the right side, you push back this band that's already here, already looped. Pick up the band underneath that, loop it forward. Then you're actually going to go back one pin and now loop the zigzag band. So Okay, pick up the zigzag band and loop it back upon itself diagonally. Well, back to where the other end is. It's like that. And then you loop the border again. So on the left side, you push back everything except for the bottom two, because the bottom two are this border band and the zigzag band. You pick up the border band and you loop it forward. Whoops. And on the right side, you don't really have to push back anything, just pick up the border band and loop it forward. And preferably don't let go of it like I did. No problem. Then go back to this second pin on the left, push back, and pick up the zigzag band on the bottom. And then loop this diagonally up to the right. And now loop the border, the two border bands, one on each side. And then go back into this pin that's one below the one on the right. And loop the zigzag band diagonally to the left, back upon itself, back to where the other end of it is. And you should be picking up on the pattern that you'll loop each side of the border, then you loop the zigzag band, then you loop the border, then the zigzag band, and so on. So you'll do this all the way up the loom for the rest of the bracelet. So you'll loop the bracelet like that all the way up to the top of the loom. And then the last band you need to loop is this band. So you go into the left side, pick it up, and loop it over to the right side where the zigzag band is. Like that. Then you put your hook into that pin, and you take another border band, and pull it up through the pin, making sure not to snag your hook on any other band while doing that. Then you put the other end on the hook, and you can remove the bracelet from the loom. Now all we have to do is add an extension. All I have to do. And also just stretch any bands if they're to make it look neater if you need to. Like if you have dual layer bands and the wrong side's showing. For example. Okay. So now turn your loom back around and just add simple extension up one side, or the center column if you wanted to, of the like that. Then turn your loom around. Attach the bracelet like that. Push back the bracelet so that you can pick up this first extension band. Loop it forward and just loop the extension as usual. And then remove the extension from the loom. Then you're going to take it off the hook. Just attach the C-clip like usual. Like that. And just attach the C-clip to the other end. So there you have your completed power out bracelet. Hope you enjoyed.